Hey Ivy, you look so nice today. Anything important later
Oh, hey
on?
Paul. Nice to see you. Yeah, I just had my graduation and we are going to have a big party later tonight. How's going?
Oh God. Hear that again.
You look shocked. What did you hear that shocked you?
Graduation. I've been learning it these days and it kept appearing in my daily school life.
Interesting. So what exactly do you mean graduation?
It is a terminology in my actuarial study. Basically, it is used to refine the mortality rates which are originally crude. It is similar to what you say regression in mathematics.
I got it, but why do you try to refine them?
What we usually do is to observe mortality rate of each age from a group of people. However, those mortality rates estimated from the observation are crude, progressing roughly as I said, where we believe that the real rate are likely to be smooth functions of age.
Maybe in reality they really are crudely distributed?
Nah. It is because we don't investigate the whole population but to extract sample from population, hence sampling errors would certainly exist.
I see. So the main reason for you to graduate is to remove the sampling errors, right?
Exactly. And we also want to produce a smooth line, hence to improve the rates by using information from previous or next ages.
But once you ensure smoothness, the observed mortality rates may not all be plotted on the smooth line. So I guess there is a limited space to allow the existence of error?
Right. We want the line to be not only smooth but also adherent to data. Therefore, we need to find the balance of smoothness and adherence to data.
Cool. How did you test it to find the balance?
We test the hypothesis that the true underlying mortality rate at each age X for the experience are the graduated rates. Firstly, we find the number of deaths from either Poisson model or binomial model, and then we compare these with the actual number of deaths.
And how do you compare them?
I just simply follow the normal hypothesis statistical test. There are two type of tests, chi-square test and standard deviation test.
Then how about smoothness?
For smoothness we calculate the third differences of the graduated rate. Intrinsically it is the measure and the curvature. If the third difference is small in magnitude compared to graduated rate and it progresses regularly with age, then it is satisfied.
Great. Remind me the derivatives. Anything else should be noticed about?
Yeah, you should also keep your eye on the suitability for purpose in hand. Basically it is what you are using the data results for. If the result is for life insurance, it should not be underestimated. If underestimated, people will be assumed to live longer, and the price of insurance will go down, which reduces the company's competitive advantage. However, if the data is for pension, it should not be overestimated because when people are assumed to die earlier, government will not prepare too much fund and a shortage of funds will appear.
I got it. You are a good explainer. I believe you will be excellent in your actuarial studies.
Thank you, Ivy. I am still improving myself. Okay, I will let you go now. Have fun in the party tonight. See you later.
Thanks, Paul. Have a good day. Bye.